There's no one on the sea. We don't see any sails. The only thing we see are two commercial boats. We moved to the Croatian coastline, so we have some shelter from the islands. And now we are going south.
We had some trouble with the boat. It was during the night, Benjamin was sleeping, and yeah, filming wasn't our main priority.
So as this may seem like a beautiful sail, and it was a beautiful sail for 90% of the time, but for 10% of the time, we had some, let's say, uncomfortable moments. So here's the real story.
We are Rianne and Garben, and this is our son Benjamin. We made a few mistakes in life and experienced some challenges.
Cancer, bankruptcy, depressions, and a divorce.
They ignited us in creating our reality.
For now, sailing around the world to find our home somewhere on our planet.
So welcome to our weekly vlog, from raw sailing to slow living.
Embracing the race of life.
So what an interesting day. Yeah, we had a fantastic sail with Mirko and his lady and his friend, where he built the boat with, and they even helped us out with some big groceries because we are now on our way towards Sicily. So it's we left the marina at around 7 o'clock in the evening, and now it's almost 8. So the moon is getting up. We have around 15 knots of wind, and we are sailing towards the Croatian coast. If necessary, we can find some shelter over there if the storm hits. Yeah, at the good side of the Adriatic for the coming days and the coming winds, so we can go south. And yeah, it was just beautiful to sail together. And Benjamin and Rianne, they are on in the bed because they got a little bit seasick because there were big waves coming in because the current was going out and the wind was and the waves were going in, so it was really uncomfortable though. So they are a little bit seasick now, and I hope they will recover. We have almost full sails on. It's between the 18 and 20 knots of wind, so we're making good progress. So I'm gonna show you outside. Coastline is over there, and we are almost direction of Pula. So we made, let's see, 65 nautical miles. We crossed some shipping lanes. We had some wind between the 18 and the 8 knots of wind, some speed between 8 and 3 knots. So yeah, making good progress. There's no one on the sea. We don't see any sails. The only thing we see are two commercial boats. It's blowing at a steady 22, 23, sometimes a gust with 25, 26 knots of wind. The sun is shining. We're really beating into the waves. But feeling the breeze. Coastline, so we have some shelter from the islands, and now we are going south, hardly any waves, making miles, and up to tomorrow there's good wind for going south. After that it will change, and the weather at the moment is really crazy in Sicily, so it's good to be here. And there is someone waking up. Benjamin. So as this may seem like a beautiful sail, and it was a beautiful sail for 90% of the time, but for 10% of the time we had some, let's say, uncomfortable moments. So here's the real story.
Yeah, so as we left Chioggia, we left in the dark. I was getting quite seasick. We had big waves, we had some trouble with the boat. It was during the night, Benjamin was sleeping, and yeah, filming wasn't our main priority, and to be honest, we're not that good at filming in the dark yet. We thought we were going to share the story with you because it is part of our life on the boat, and we want to give you a real reflection of how our lives is and what it means to live on a boat and to travel around the world and visit all those amazing places. And boat life is for 90% pretty amazing, but 10% it isn't.
Where to start?
Yeah, I think we can start with that we picked our weather window very carefully.
Yeah. Yeah, because we are sailing from Chioggia all the way down to the south tip of Italy, and it's around a 5-day sail, and you can't find really good shelter on the Italian coastline. Because in autumn times, the Adriatic, it's getting really tough, because when the wind shifts from the southerlies to the northerlies, then there is a chance that you pick up the Bora, and the Bora, it's a strong wind, and it can pick up to between 30 to 35 knots, but we've got up to 50 and even more. So we really have to be careful. And we picked a beautiful weather window.
Yeah. And we heard a lot of bad stories about boats getting in distress and on the Adriatic Sea. So it can be really spooky out there.
Yeah.
Yeah. But we picked this beautiful weather window. So the wind There were strong winds from the southern part, and then they shifted towards the northern part. And as we noticed when we were in Venice, we kept a close eye on how the weather was forming and transforming and evolving within the Adriatic Sea. As soon as you have a wind shift, you have a couple of days of beautiful sailing opportunities.
Yeah, to go south. But you have to keep in mind that the rollers, the big waves, are coming from the south.
Yeah, that's where we made a little bit of a mistake. So the wind shifted from southern to northern, and as that happened, we left the marina, and it was a really small marina, and within 2 minutes we were in the lagoon. But what was happening in the lagoon, there were extremely big waves. So that you had the waves from the Adriatic Sea that were building up with the long time of the southern winds, and they were pushed into the lagoon, and they were getting even higher, and it was pretty rough.
Yeah, because at one side they got pushed in a narrow entrance of the lagoon, and on the other side the current was going out, so the waves were really building, and the boat was really slamming, and the waves were rolling on the deck.
Yeah, so that we didn't plan. No.
So we were kind of in a relaxed mode. Okay, we're gonna start our 5-day journey. You gotta please pick up the fenders and put them in the Alfa Lazarette. But
so within 2 minutes we were out of the protection of the marina, and then it was really tough already, and it was dark, so we couldn't really see how big the waves were, but they were really, really, really big. So I was struggling to get the fenders into the locker at the aft deck. I kept the aft deck open so I would not struggle with opening it and closing it again, and could put in the fenders quite easily. And Gerben was managing the boat with the quite heavy waves during the small channel. And with doing that, we had some rollers onto the deck, some waves. And at that moment, we didn't realize it, but we also got quite some seawater waves into the locker.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, but we didn't notice. So I closed the hatch after we finished the big waves, and you were downstairs with Benjamin because Benjamin was seasick.
Yeah, Benjamin was sitting downstairs having his dinner, and he was getting really seasick. So I was helping Benjamin, but then I got seasick as well because it was really uncomfortable downstairs, yeah, below deck.
Yeah, but after, let's say it was, I think, 20 minutes, half an hour, maybe?
Half an hour, yeah.
Half an hour, we got in a better sea state and we started sailing, and we were going south, so we had a good sail going south.
Yeah. But as you ever have been seasick, you notice that once you get seasick, it's really hard to get it out of your system. So Benjamin was really struggling, and I was struggling as well, and it was time for him to go to bed. So I brought him to the master cabin and tried to bring him to sleep. And it took me around 2 hours before he was comfortable again, and eventually he fell asleep. But that didn't last all very long, because when I was below deck, I could hear over the winds and the waves.
Rianne is very sensitive, so she noticed everything, from water, from sound, from smell. So I was
enjoying yourself with the night sail.
Yeah, so then Rianne asked me, Gerben, there's water in the boat, and yeah. I was, oh no.
Yeah.
Not now, because I'm sailing. But I went down, and then you asked me, you said that you heard some water.
Yeah.
So I took out the drawers and...
I heard the water, I took my flashlight, and I saw even water coming out of the floorboard. So yeah.
Because we were healing.
Yeah. So, and we never had that it comes out of the floorboard. So I knew it was a lot of water. So then you came down, and we took all the floorboards up, and what's good to know is that we have compartments, and that means that if the water comes somewhere in the boat, it goes via this water flow that is structured by these compartments. So what we did, we followed the water flow back to the source with the compartments, and we pretty soon realized that it was the water that came in with the sail locker when I was putting the fenders in.
Yeah, because the first thing you do is you taste the water. When it's sweet water, then
it's okay.
Then it's okay, because that is from inside the boat. But when it's salt water, yeah. then you have a problem. And it was salt water, of course.
Yeah.
But
so we had in first instance we had a little bit of distress, but then we just said, okay, let's find the source, and then we know how serious the problem is.
Yeah.
And then when we knew what it was like, okay, we can do two things now: let the water slowly run towards the bilge or pump it out. And we decided to pump it out because we didn't want to get all the floorboards pretty wet. And
no, and yeah, you just want to get it out and want to have a dry boat.
Yeah. So as Gerben was still saying, we had pretty high wind still. It was a good sail, but you had to be very careful.
Yeah, it was 20 knots of wind and full sails out, so...
Yeah. So Gerben was running up and down, I was pumping, he was pumping, and as I was...
It's very good for your species.
Yeah, so I was hanging upside down, and so it didn't get any better. So that this was actually the first night, and the first night I think we were at 4 o'clock in the morning, we were finished with all the water inside the boat.
Yeah.
So both of us didn't get any sleep during this first night.
No. No.
As we had this 5 days opportunity to cross down towards Sicily, we decided to cross towards Croatia a little bit, and just so we were on the side of Croatia from the Adriatic Sea. So if something would go wrong, or if the wind would change, or there would become really bad weather, we had the opportunity to go to the Croatian islands and find some shelter, because the coast of Italy doesn't have many opportunities for shelter.
No.
So that's why we decided to first move towards Croatia and then change our direction more south.
Yeah. Yeah, but while doing that, we got into a shipping lane and the VTS called us that we had to change our course. And I tried to tag, but the waves were too high to tag without using the engine. So then that was for me the moment to start the engine. And when I start the engine and I tagged, then Rianne said, the engine doesn't run that smooth. So I had to check the engine, and it turned out that we had some dirt in the diesel again.
Yeah, and we fueled up a little bit in Italy because we wanted to make sure that we had enough diesel in the tanks for if something would go wrong, we could motor.
Yeah.
So when that happened, and it's actually an easy fix, you can clean your filters and then the motor runs again, and then probably you have to do that 2-3 times again because There's more dirt in the diesel.
Yeah, we cleaned the filter, and I did the fuel water separator, so because there was too much water in the fuel.
Yeah, so you can do that. So it's an easy fix, but still, with everything that happened, we decided, okay, we're not feeling that comfortable and secure anymore. We had the water in the boat, we had now the engine, so. Things weren't running smoothly, and we have this rule for ourselves: if it doesn't run smoothly, maybe we should stop, rest a little bit, and try it again. So we decided, okay, we go to Croatia now. We were at the territory borders. We're gonna drop anchor, we're gonna check everything out, and then if it's okay, we're gonna exit Croatia again and move towards Sicily.
Yeah.
And we read online that we have the opportunity to transit for 11 hours in Croatian territory water, and we thought, okay, 11 hours, we will have time enough to check this, and then if we need to stay, we're going to check in. If everything is okay, we're going to leave again and try to catch the rest of this beautiful weather window.
Yeah.
So we entered Croatia in the middle of the night. We dropped anchor, but we...
In the bay we know from before.
Yeah, so in Pula. We dropped anchor. We want to wait for the light. It was like 3-4 hours. It would be light. The sun would come up.
Yeah.
But we even didn't get to that point before we knew it. The port police was already next to our boat and find us. And we needed to check in immediately. We were not allowed to leave again. And well, it was a lot of hassle. We tried to explain our situation. We said we have the right for the 11 hours of transit, but they say, no, you are Schengen law now, you should check in, and that's it.
Yeah, so we tried to fix the problem. So we solved the water problem completely, and I couldn't completely fix the engine problem, but yeah, we tried to sail up to Pula to do a proper check-in.
Yeah, so
what we did.
Yeah. And as we already were checked in Croatia, we thought, okay, then what we can do now is also not do the big sail again, but just sail along the islands down south more and have more protection and take it a little bit more slow.
Yeah.
And we make use of the opportunity to return the outboard engine to the amazing family that landed out to us.
Yeah, so we don't have to...
So we didn't have to be creative to get that one back again if we were in Sicily or somewhere else.
Yeah.
So trying to do this crossing towards Sicily, we ended up in Croatia where we didn't want to be. We have got a lot of seasickness, we got engine trouble, water in the boat, we got a fine. And yeah, we ended up without an outboard engine.
Yeah.
So
perfectly ready to go a longer crossing.
Yeah. So, but other than that, we had really a beautiful sail, as you could see in the footage, but we want to share this part as well. So yeah, we hope you enjoyed this vlog. And if you're new here, don't forget to subscribe and give us a thumbs up. And yeah, we'd love to see you next week.
Yeah. In our journey going south through the Kornati and towards Šibenik.
Yeah, so it's gonna be autumn sailing in Croatia next vlog.
No champagne sailing.
No champagne sailing, no. Rough sailing. Some.
Slow living.
And slow living. Slow sailing and rough sailing. Both.
Embrace the waves of life.
Yes. Thank you guys.
Bye bye.
Well, mornings like these, waking up like this, having breakfast here on the side of the bow of the boat, I couldn't wish for anything else.
So waking up at 2 o'clock in the morning, because there is a good weather window, checked everything. Should be 15 up to 20 knots of wind.